multiply yourselves. And really all it will take is just that one person that you register to vote, that one person that you get out to the polls, that one person that you talk to and help them understand what's at stake. Mm-hmm. I want people to be thinking that that one could be the one that puts us over the top,
gotcha.
Especially when you think about how an election is broken down over precincts and counties and communities. We've seen close elections. It could come down to the last 500 people.
Mm-hmm.
So for anyone who doesn't feel like, you know, the thing I can do won't make a difference, we're just trying to change that, because all it will take is one. And if each of us does our one,
mm-hmm.
and all of us know that one person in our lives, right? That one knucklehead nephew that's not registered to vote,
mm-hmm.
you know, that one neighbor that's not really paying attention, or that one person in your office that's confused about how Barack's tax plan will benefit that individual. Those are going to be the conversations that make the difference. And in this election, we're going to be making a choice about how we want our democracy run. You know, do we want our president selected by people rolling their sleeves up, knocking on doors, or are we going to hand it over to a couple of people who write big checks? And we've invested throughout not just this campaign, but throughout Barack's first term in building organizations on the ground, because it's not just about choosing the next president, it's about choosing what the next tax plan is going to be, or whether we actually tackle global warming, or whether our kids can go to school without a mountain of debt.